Teşekkür etmiş.
Ben şey yaptım Ayşe Kız Hoca'ya.
Tamam.
30-30'da başlayalım.
Bir süre sen şey iş mesajı yaptın. Onlar normal o kadar.
Ne Ayşe Kız Hoca yazıyor.
Ben zannettim 70-80 tane mesaj var.
Yani kime göre çok kime
göre. Balon yapmış. Balon yapmış. Sen mutfağa geçtin mi?
Yani.
YouTube'da canlı yayındasın.
Tamam.
Arkadaşlar kulaklığınız varsa kulaklığınızı takın. Şimdi 3 kişiyiz aynı yerde. Sonra sesler karışıyor. Oğul bir senin mi?
Benimki çok aşık
bir oğul. Sizde.
Merhabalar. Merhaba. Sesim geliyor mu acaba?
Evet, ses geliyor.
Tamam.
Evet hocam. Şu an
Buket hocam.
Onu kasmıyor hocam.
Bir dakika. Hocam hoş geldiniz.
Merhabalar.
Tamam.
Bir sorun yok.
Tamam. Senin başkan da gelmiş. Tamam.
Evet geliyor. Kaos çatın siz.
Merhaba hocam.
Merhaba. Buket hocam merhaba.
Merhabalar hocam.
Nasılsınız?
İyiyim, sağ olun. Sizler nasılsınız?
Merhaba Dilek. Teşekkür ederiz. Biraz benim sesim mi yankı yapıyor acaba?
Yok, aslında iyi geliyor sesiniz. Evet. Sadece yankı geliyor bu oturumda sunacak arkadaşlar mı olacak hocam?
Sunacaklar, isteyenler de dinleyici olarak katılabiliyor.
Yani şu an kodlarını gördüğümüz arkadaşlar sunacak iki kişi. Onun dışında katılacaklar da dahil olabiliyor, öyle mi?
Burada sesli.
Buket hocam duyuyor musun?
Duyuyorum hocam.
Hocam şimdi biz de acemiyiz. Bir şeyler karışıyor. YouTube'dan bir taraftan canlı yayın kuruyoruz. 20 saniye sonra geliyor. Şimdi benim 20 saniye önce söylediğim şey burada YouTube'da açık olunca oradan da geldi. Tamam. Ondan ben kendi sesimi duydum. Belki siz duymadınız. Ama evet. Tamam, şimdi iyi. Öğrenciler herhalde katılacaklar. Oturumda sunum yapacak öğrenciler artı dinlemek isteyen olursa normal salonlardaki gibi onlar da katılabiliyor. Bir 5 dakikamız falan var. Herhalde katılırlar.
Bizim bu noktada müdahale edeceğimiz herhangi bir şey yok değil mi hocam?
Şimdi bizim burada gördüğünüz arkadaş, bunu açmıyor zaten. O içeri katılmak isteyenleri alıyor zaten. Admit edecek. Tamam. Siz sadece normal kongrede nasıl şey yapıyorsanız, elinizde program da var. Evet. İşte ilk oturumdan başlatıyorsunuz. İkinci dilekmiş. Hani gelmeyen falan olursa artık ona göre oturumu normal oturumlardaki bu ayarlıyorsunuz. Girip çıkanı Malat kontrol ediyor. Sekreterimiz Malat. Sen tanıt kendini. Tamam.
Tamam.
Hocam müsaadenizle ben ayrılıyorum. Tamam. Görüşürüz.
Görüşürüz.
Evet hocam. Merhaba.
Merhabalar.
Ben Malat Necres Iraklıyım.
Güzel.
Ege Üniversitesi yüksek lisans öğrenciyim.
Yüksek lisans mı yapıyorsun?
Evet. Şimdi mezun oldum. Uluslararası Bilgisayar Enstitüsü'nden Bilgi Teknolojileri.
O çok güzel. Yeni mezunlardan.
Evet. Evet, yeni mezun.
Hayırlısı olsun.
Teşekkür ederim.
Malat, peki soru cevabı nasıl halledeceğiz?
Şu an sunum 15 dakika olacak. Evet. Evet, aynen, yani sorusu olan varsa ya yazıyor ya da direkt soruyor. Burada yazıyor, chat var diye bir
şey. Belki direkt de sorabilir. Onun dışında mikrofon evet. Kapalı kalmalı bence.
Burada chat var, sorabilir burada.
Sorabilir.
Evet.
Sümeyye'ciğim merhaba.
Evet, evet. Hocam 4 dakika kaldı. Hocam merhaba. Hoş geldin. Gayret Çevik'te.
Merhabalar.
Merhabalar.
Bir sekreterimiz var. O kontrolü teknik olarak idare edip siz normal öğrencilere sırayla ya da sunum yapacak kişilere sırayla davet edersiniz. İlk sunum zaten sizin öğrencinizin herhalde. O değil onun.
Sen görmüyorsun. Sen görmüyorsun. Hocaya şey yapman lazım.
Hı?
Canlı yayında.
Canlı mı?
Yok.
Şimdi
7'de
8'de. Bunu başlayıp
da spiker veriyor musun?
Sen sesini kapat. Konuşacağım tamam.
İyi bir oturum diliyorum. Çok teşekkür ederim hocam. İnşallah sizi daha sonra ziyarete de gel.
Şu an ME-2007 başlayabiliyor.
Başlayalım mı?
Evet hocam.
Tamam. Hoş geldiniz arkadaşlar. Bir problem yok. Başlıyoruz değil mi arkadaşlar? Good afternoon. Welcome to second session of the fourth International Students Science Congress. I am Buket Okutan Baba of mechanical. I am a professor at Mechanical Engineering Department in İzmir Katip Çelebi University. In this session, we have six presentation about composite materials. Each presenter has 15 minutes, exactly 15 minutes to deliver the presentation and also for question and answer. Now, I want to invite the first presenter, Jassim El Samari. I think he's here, isn't it? Samari is in here? Or Halis Kandaş? I want to invite to present your presentation, okay?
Hocam onun sesi gelmiyor.
Balat nasıl ayarlayabiliriz?
Kapattım.
Tamam şimdi.
Şimdi gelmesi lazım hocam. Ekranı görebiliyor musunuz?
Görebiliyoruz.
Evet.
The title of your presentation in the different, I think.
Yeah, bir dakika.
We wait impact and compression after impact behavior of laminated composite plates.
Bir dakika. Oh. Değiştirmiş mi? Şey yap.
Okay, okay.
Bir dakika şey yapalım.
Okay, mı? Yes, please. Yapsın. We'll listen to you.
Hello everyone. My name is Halis Kandaş. I'm from 9 Eylül University. Since the original presenter, the Adil Kadum is sick. I'm going to make the presentation. First of all, I want to first, I want to introduce the Kevlar carbon fibers significance. The previous papers in many areas shows the importance of the Kevlar and carbon fibers upon use. The many application areas of these materials are aerodynamics, constructions, marine and industry, etc. These materials prefer in these areas because of their effectiveness and their conditional properties. These materials mostly used in vacuum-assisted resin infusion molding process. We prefer this method too. And the basic reason we prefer Kevlar and carbon materials is because they are used in many areas, specific areas. First, let me say about the aim of our research. In our study, we first produce the Kevlar carbon fiber laminates. In this study, we Kevlars we use are woven type Kevlar carbon. They are hybridly manufactured, and We first investigate the impact response of these materials, but we use the flat nose impactor in the study and use in 5 different energies, as you can see here, 5 joule, 15 joule, 5 different impact. And after the impact, we carried out the compression tests to the loaded and unloaded materials. Sorry. After this, we can have an idea about these materials, both in impact and compression after impact responses of these materials. As I said, we use the Kevlar and carbon fiber hybrids. In this one sheet, we have both carbon and Kevlar material and MGS epoxy resin and hardener from the company, in this company. As I said earlier, we use the vacuum assisted resin infusion molding method. It's most commonly used method in these materials. And for this, for curing process took 8 hours in at 800 centigrade degree. As a result of process, we have a very large composite plates, as you well know, and we size it to the compression after impact test specimens. Even we use first impact test, this is the final size we needed, and it's the 1500 to 100 millimeter size. We cut it with the we use the water cooling saw, so we minimize the damage in the specimens. And after the sizing method, we use the Tractovis Plus impact machine, which resides in Doksel University. This device has an head impactor with 22 kilonewton impact load capacity, and we use this, as you can see here, a flat impactor. This is the head of the impactor. We use all our testers in 23 centigrade degree, meaning room temperature. After the impact test, we use our own design compression device in Shimatsu Universal Test Machine. And this is the compression device, as you can see here. After this, we first investigate the impact responses, and we started it with velocity time impact responses. In velocity time graphics, as you can see here, the velocity start with the positive side, but it's actually and downward takes as positive. So you shouldn't have wrong ideas about it's going to the negative side. It means it's from here, it goes the opposite direction, the upward. And as you can see here, until the 15 joules, we don't have any continuum in positive sides. This means this 15 joule is the penetration situation, since it's continuous after the specimen. After this, we investigated first maximum contact force and impact energy graphics. And as you can see here, in flat noses, the all contact forces rises with the rising impact energy. Even it's getting a lower rise, low level of rising, it still continues to rise. So we can make for this material the flat impact keep after the flat impact, the contact force will keep rising with rising of the impact energy. For the other type of impacts, so we cannot be that sure about that. And lastly, about the impact investigations, we investigated the absorbed energy, impact energy graphics. And as you can see here, first we have the rebounding case. After this, the 12.5 joule, we reached the 12.5 joule. And as you can see here, in here, absorbed energy becomes equal to the impact energy. And we can say it's the limit of penetration. And after that, it keeps rising, it cannot rise to the 15 joules. So in here we have the penetration situation. As we have concluded in velocity diagram. And after that, lastly, we have stress deflection diagram of the compression after impact tests. As you can see here, after we used also the unloaded specimen. This way we can see more clearly the effect of the impact. And here, with the rising of the impact energy, the stress, maximum stress value of the compression keeps lowering, and in 15 joule, there is a serious drawback in the maximum stress level. And we can conclude that the penetration have a more serious effect than the other impact situations. And we conclude the final velocity value stays in the positive sides after penetration. Meaning 15 joule is the penetration situation for this material. Maximum contact force keeps increasing in the flat nose with the rising of the impact energy. But this is only for the flat nose. We cannot be sure about that for the other types of the impact shapes. And the absorbed energy values keep increasing with the impact energy level, even after the penetration. Lastly, we have concluded that the maximum stress of the compression after impact of these hybrid composites decrease with increasing impact energy, especially after the penetration. These are some references, and thank you for your attention.
Okay, thank you very much for your presentation.
Any questions?
Is there anybody to ask some questions?
Kapalı durumda ses hocam.
Beni duymuyor musunuz?
Yok.
Yazabilirsinler.
If you have any question, please write from the chat button. Have you got any question? I think there is no question.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for your good presentation.
Thank you.
Now, I want to invite a second presenter, Dilek Atilla. Her presentation title is Investigation of Two-Dimensional Mechanical Metamaterial Having Different Shapes. Okay. Yes, please, Dilek Atilla.
Can,
Hocam sesini açabilirsin. Hocam sesin kapalı. Evet şu an.
Ama Dilek'in sesini açman gerekiyor Malat.
Tamam.
Okay. I want to invite second presenter Dilek Atilla.
Var zaten.
Tamam, şimdi oldu.
Tamam.
Firstly, I would like to welcome dear professors and participants. My name is Dilek Atilla. Today I will present my study on two-dimensional metamaterials. I share my presentation. Can you see?
Yes.
Okay. Its name is Investigation of Two-Dimensional Mechanical Metamaterials Having Atomic Different Shapes. Oxidic materials are the subtopic of the metamaterials. Oxidity is an phenomenon that has been studied in recent years due to properties of negative Poisson ratio. Unlike materials with a positive Poisson ratio, these materials expand with the pulling force and contract with the compression force. Seen in the figure, when applied to tensile force a material, positive Poisson ratio material decrease in cross-section, but oxidic materials not like this. When applied a force, tensile force, cross-section is increased. The definition of these materials with a negative Poisson ratio name is oxidic materials, was first described in 1991 by Professor Dr. Evans. Although named by Evans, the existence of negative Poisson ratio has been proven in previous studies. One of the studies is Lake's work, which was studied on polyurethane foam in 1987 with oxidic effect. Various oxidic materials have been produced from polymers, composites, metals, and ceramics after Lake realized the oxidic effect in Mateman polyurethane foam. For this reason, it has been subject of the studies in various fields like in architecture, in buildings, biomedical, clinic prosthesis, ballistics, sport equipments like Nike sports shoes, and soft robotics like robot fingers, and many other fields. In addition, its adaptability to all areas, it has superior properties compared to many materials. One of them is that they have a synclastic feature. In other words, it can take form of a dome and it is adaptational. Inclined surface can be performed more easily. In first figure, A is anticlastic, B is cylindrical, and C is synclastic material. Additionally, the oxidic materials have high indentation resistance and energy absorption ability. Because conventional materials are subjected to impact loads, materials flow away from the impact points like this and like this. While oxidic materials flow towards the impact points, it is re-entrant shape. When impact points applied on surface, materials flow towards the impact points. In addition to these properties, oxidic materials have characteristic properties such as shear resistance, acoustic absorption ability, etc. Oxidic shapes consisting of cells can be designed in two and three dimensions. However, it is impossible to produce complex shapes with electron laser melting. acoustic deposition, acoustic production methods such as casting and turning. Therefore, selection electron laser melting, acoustic deposition method, etc. is used as the production method. Some of the obstacles in this production methods are expensive materials and long production time. Another problem is the uncertainty of the measuring range, because there was no standard for measurement yet. And the measurement range is an important factor, especially in determining poisson ratio, which proves the presence of exotic effects. The aim of the study is to examine the effect of changing star shape on poisson ratio, as well as production time and amount of material. In this study, the pin checkoff like this, in reference shape. Oxytic pattern and adding circular hole and rhombus hole shown in figures was examined to determine oxytic core with high poison ratio, where less material can be used for faster production. It is peanut shape hole reference set and adding circular hole and rhombus hole. There are many different 3D printing methods depending on the material. One of the most widely being material used for the first deposition method is polylactic acid, PLA. In this study, PLA material was chosen to compare with the reference article, and its mechanical properties were given below, given elastic modulus, poisson ratio, and densities. Material and methods. The dimensions were determined by using reference article to create the peanut shape geometry. Figure is illustrated that design of the peanut shape hole is used for creating unit cell and hole geometry obtained by the repeating sequence. Formula is given like that. The unit cell was created using the values in the reference article. For reference peanut shape hole, validation of results. The reference peanut shape cell is designed for L equals to 12 and half millimeters. Wide and length is equal. In addition, different unit cells shown in figure were created by adding rhombus and circular holes of different thickness to the reference peanut shape. Thickness D is determined as 0.28 millimeter and 0.50 millimeter for design distribution. Four cross eight cells were obtained by arranging the unit cells to form four rows next to each other and eight columns below. Four cross eight cells were created since numerical analysis was performed and the change of Poisson's value was observed for different measurement range. In addition, eight cross eight cells and eight cross 16 cells were created, then how the Poisson ratio change was observed, where as measurement range was changed. One cell is given a green sequence. In boundary conditions, the reference peanut shape unit cell shown in the figure is fixed at points C and D, like that. The displacements were given in the y direction in proportion as 8%, 16%, and 24% of the AC distance from points A and B. In addition, a 4 cross 8 size model was fixed and displaced as shown in the figure, one end fixed and displacement applied other end. And the measurement range is an important factor for determining the poison ratio. Although it's significant, there was not standard for measurement yet. For this reason, in order to eliminate the uncertainty, the poison ratio was obtained by different measurement range that are shown in the figure. This study was carried out at 1 millimeter displacement value when L equals to 20 and half millimeter stream was applied at the y direction, at the one end and other end fixed like this. The painting time and material usage amounts to be painted on the surface were determined through the C-suite program. It is thought that the parts will be made of PLA material, polylactic acid, at full feed rate. Filament yüzeyden thermolus given in table. Chain was applied on the reference cell as described in the boundary conditions to make verification, and it was observed how the EF distance changed against the change of AC distance. When the article and ancestor results of the reference figure are examined, it seems that the rate of change of the EF distance is very close to each other, like shaded area. In 8% strain, it is 1 millimeter strain, was applied. In article, displacement is 1.25 and ancestor result is 1.23. It is very close. In addition, the Von Mises stress distribution is the same for the same strain values between reference articles like this, and ancestor analysis for peanut shape can see in this figure. The figure is very close. After the verification are carried out, ancestor analysis is performed for samples with rhombus and circular holes. Displacement results are shown in the table and figure. In addition, Von Mises stress results are shown in table and figure for all samples. Although the hole and rhombus hole were added, the mass was reduced. It was observed that the stress and displacement values of the samples were very close to each other, except for the rhombus cells, shown in red circle. This happens because the wall thickness is very thin. For the 4x8 cell configuration consisting of reference cell, circle and rhombus cells, the Poisson ratio values were calculated and presented in table. In the article, the reference 4x8 cell Poisson ratio was calculated as minus 1.20. The difference between article and ancestor is...
Hocam, arkadaşım 4 dakikası var.
Okay, 3%. It is a very acceptable rate. The Poisson ratio of cells with circular and rhombus holes are minus 1.12 and minus 1.8 respectively. With the additional force, the oxidative effect preserves. The additional force reduced the use of filament and production time. Minimum filament usage and production time have been seen in the production of the shape with rhombus hole. This means that the cost that is proportional to the raw material and device usage time will decrease. In order to eliminate the uncertainty and obtain a valid measurement range, the Poisson ratio was obtained by determining different measurement range. As can be seen in the table, the Poisson ratio changes as the measurement range changes. Okay. The Poisson ratio decreases as it gets closer to the holders, figure 1, 2, 3 area, and drops suddenly where it's close to the holders, fourth area. In order to make an accurate measurement, it is necessary to determine the Poisson ratio from middle region, not too close to the holders. We calculate strain X and strain Y, then calculate Poisson ratio. When the article and ancestor result of the reference peanut shape figure are examined, verification is provided. In the article, the reference Poisson ratio was calculated. The difference between article and ancestor is a very acceptable rate. Also, with the additional force, the oxidative effect is preserved. It was observed that the stress and displacement values of the specimens were very close to each other, except for the rhombus cells sample of only 1.28 millimeter thickness. This happens because the wall thickness is very thin. The addition of force reduced the use of filament and production time. Minimum filament use and production time have been seen in the production of the shape with rhombus point. The poison ratio decreases as it gets closer to the holders and drops suddenly where it close to the holders. In order to make a creative measurement, it is necessary to determine a poison ratio from the middle region, not close to the holders. Maximum 75% from length. Thank you for listening.
Okay, thank you very much for your presentation. Now I can take questions. Have you got any questions? Is there any question?
Hocam, Salim bir sorusu. Evet, bir arkadaşım. Tamam. Şimdi konuşabilir.
Salim, you can ask your question.
Question. You get the this results by ANSYS simulation. Did you check the mesh? If you change the mesh, you can get the same results? This is very important because you have different shape and different mesh. If the mesh effect of your result, you can compile of it. And thank you.
Yes, we use same mesh. Convergage analysis are used.
No, I mean just the size of element in the mesh. If you change the size of element, you will get the same result.
Yes, convergence analysis is used before. Then select the same mesh size, then apply it.
Okay, then if you have to add it in the new result because this is very important. Now they are checking for the mesh. If you change the mesh, you have get different results or not because it is finite element. In finite element, if you know, if you change the size of mesh and you will change the type of a grid, you will get maybe different results for changing the shape.
Yes, you are right. Mm-hmm. After convergence studies, actually, the results are given in here.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you. And now I want to invite other presenters. His presentation is about effects of cross-heat speed and penetrator shape on the punch shear behaviors of sandwich composites. I want to give Rıfat Sarıoğlu.
Hello, I'm Rıfat. My subject is effects of cross-head speed and penetrator shape of the punch shear behaviors and sandwich on composites. First of all, sandwich composites is included that two components. One component is core material. Other material is a face skin or named that face skin. And the core is very light and high bending stiffness and maximum durability. More durable and the bending stiffness. Sandwich structures are increasing aviation, defense, and aerospace industries day by day. Composite materials are subjected to dynamic and static loads in their lifetime, especially matrix cracking or fiber cracking of breakage, delamination, dishing information, etc. Aim for the research is in the study co-static tests in core PVC core and a glass face sheet sandwich composites. Five different speeds, 1 millimeter, 1 millimeter minutes per minute, 5 millimeter per minute, 15 millimeter per minute, 25 millimeter per minute, and 50 millimeter per minute. Are different co-static tests carry out the two different impact interface, hemispherical and flat surfaces. I used composite materials manufacturing, epoxy resin, a glass fiber, and PVC foam. Method, the experiments methods were performed on sandwich composites. Sandwich composites was produced by vacuum assisted resin infusion method, warm methoding. In the manufacturing, PVC core material thickness 10 millimeter and SEK glass fabric are density is 1900 gram per meter squared were used. For each face sheet, glass fabrics, four layers were used. Four layer up layer and four layer down layer. Space specimens were cut dimensions 100 millimeter square, 100 millimeter square, millimeter square. Specimens were cut dimension 1 millimeter square and square. Then co-static punch shear were applied in Dokuzeli University Shimatsu test machine. And both penetrates flat and hemispherical nozzles punch shear test fixture. Tests are confectious 5 various crosshead speeds and 3 repeats each test. 1 millimeter, 5 millimeter, and 50 millimeter for crosshead when you are chosen co-static tests. Experimental results, contact force and deformation for hemispherical. Hemispherical forces 1 millimeter, 5 millimeter, 15 millimeter, 25 millimeter, 15 millimeter. First peak increased crosshead speeds, and this subject. The maximum contact force found that newton. When the sandwich is shear stress first. First sandwich is shear stress softer and contact force. The foam crushing force and sandwich are after first sandwich was crushed smoothly in the graph. Hemispherical forces reach second sandwich layer. It's the maximum shear force and maximum contact force was found. In the graph, force displacement for flat nozzles, force flat nozzles rises 15 millimeter per minute to second peak, especially at 3,048 newton was found. First peak is very worst peak sandwich is very smoother and fluctuated for sandwiches and rises sharply for second sandwiches and descending in was sharply descending in second sandwiches. In the Flatworth experiment, has a sharply perforation, and was crushed. Conclusion: as a result of the test, it was determined that the force at hemispherical was lower than contact force at the flat nose. The reason and the reason for this is the difference geometric shapes of noses. In the test hemispherical nose, the first big contact force have increased rise speed of the force. In second contact force, the maximum value was seen at the time 5 millimeter per minute, and decreased the forces was absorbed in with the increasing speed. When the sandwich composite is loaded with the hemispherical nose, the shear stress is softer and first sandwich. For flat noses, first peak contact force increased up 15 millimeter per minute and decreased, and the rising decreased 15 millimeter per minute. In the same way for the second peak contact force, increased by 15 millimeter per minute and decreased after 15 per millimeter. The reason why the grips come out the sharp corners in the tests made with the flat noses, because flat noses forces the material to shear. Thanks for all.
Thank you very much for your presentations. Now, again, I can take questions. Have you got any question? Okay, I think there is no question. Now, I want to attend with other presenter, who is Sümeyye Sınır. The title of the presenter is Linear Vibration Analyze of Axial Force Trigonometric Graded Material Euler-Bernoulli Beam with Variable Cross Section. Sümeyye, we are waiting you.
Okay, hi.
Hi.
I open my presentation. Yes. This study has been prepared with Dr. Çevik and Dr. Sınır, which is about linear vibration analysis of axially forced Euler-Bernoulli beam with variable cross-section. First of all, what are the functional graded materials? Functional graded materials are a kind of new homogeneous composite materials containing two or more components whose material composition continuously and smoothly varies along certain direction. The functional graded materials concepts originated in Japan in 1984 during the Space Plan project in the form of a proposed thermal barrier material capable of withstanding a surface temperature of 2000 Kelvin and a temperature grade of 1000 Kelvin across a cross section. Why functional graded materials are preferred? We can answer this question by illustrating about the disadvantages of the classical composites and the main advantages of the functional graded materials. The main advantages of the functional graded classical composites you can see, and the main advantages of the functional graded materials as you see. What are the application areas of the functional graded materials? There are organic functional graded materials in the natural as bones, teeth, humans, skins, bamboo, etc. and produced functional gradient materials, structural elements are rolls, beams, plates, shells. And functional gradient materials application areas are given in this slide. You can see. And in this slide, I give some examples of the produced equipments in the mentioned function graded materials application areas. And you can see others. Examples of the functional graded beams are turbine blades, helicopter rotor blades, robot arms, etc. Material properties variation of the beam are as in these pictures, and especially axial material properties variations are shown in cases C and D. I want to give some information about axial material gradients in the literature. The well-known material gradient is power law material gradient. Other material gradients in the literature, exponential material gradients, trigonometric and polynomial material gradients. In this study, we choose trigonometric material gradient, and according to this material gradient, elasticity modulus and density are defined as in this page. In the graph, variation of the elasticity modulus for different material gradient coefficient K2 values are shown. For the non-uniform beam, cross-section area and inertia moment are defined as respectively. The dimensional equation of motion of the beam is assumed as this form. And for material and geometry independent solutions, the equation of motion is dimensioned, and the defined non-dimensional terms are as follows in the literature. And the non-dimensional equation of motion is obtained, as you see. And the boundary conditions for pin-pin supports are given in the literature as follows. For the solution, we use differential quadrature method. In this method, the derivative of the a function may be represented as the weighted linear sum of the function values at all discrete points. The higher order derivative of the function can be given as follows. And the grid points are defined as this equation. The following relations for calculating the weighting coefficients are given. The solution of the linear equation is assumed this form, and substituting the solution into star and two star equations, one can obtain this equation system. The discretized equation of motion is calculated as this form, and discretized boundary conditions for pin-pin supports are this form. Substituting the discretized boundary conditions into the discretized equation of motion, we obtain this linear algebraic equation system. From this system, the natural frequencies and critical laws are obtained. In this, in table one, linear natural frequencies of axially trigonometric functional graded material beam with uniform cross-section area are given for three modes. And in table two, linear natural frequencies of beam with non-uniform cross-section area are given for these three modes. pardon. In case of in table one, in case of K2 and negative K2, linear natural frequencies of the beam with uniform cross section area are same, as you see. And in table two, K2 increase, linear natural frequencies of the beam with non-uniform cross section area increase. In table three, critical loss are given. In cases of K2 and negative K2, critical loss of the uniform cross section beam are same, as you see. And in table K2 increases, you see, critical loss of the non-uniform cross section beam increase. In figure one and two, the variation of the natural frequencies depending on the critical loss at different K2 values are given. Conclusion, some information about functional gradient materials properties are mentioned as components, material composition, originating advantages, etc. Some information about functional gradient materials application areas are given. For example, there are organic and produced functional gradient materials. Also, functional gradient materials are used in many areas, which are space structures, nuclear industry, defense industry, energy, biomedical, etc. Information about axially material gradients are described. Commonly used material gradients are powerlar, exponential, trigonometric, polynomial material gradients in the literature, and we use trigonometric material gradients. The equation of mass is defined and dimensioned. And the nature of frequencies and the critical loss are obtained by solving the linear equation of motion, and effects of coefficients of material gradients K2 on natural frequencies and critical loss are shown in tables and figures. Thank you for your participation and any question.
Thank you very much for your presentation. Is there any question? Do you want to ask any question? At that time, I want to ask a question. Is there any reason to select trigonometric material gradient? Why do you select?
No.
Is there any equivalent in the application? Arbitrary, or it is easy to for solution? Which one? Why did you select especially trigonometric gradient?
1 minute, I can answer this question. With what presentations closed? Okay. Sorunuzu tekrar alabilir miyim hocam? Şu anda sunumu kapatmışım da bağlantı kuramıyorum tekrar. Ha, okay.
Önemli değil, İngilizce, Türkçe fark etmez.
Siz şey soruyorsun. Bir aralık olup olmadığını soruyorsunuz. Yani trigonometrik sonuçta trigonometrik değerler olduğu için yani şey negatif ve pozitifte 1 ve 0 eksi 1 aralığında değerler alıyoruz. Şeyin ne diyeyim bu gradyanın katsayısı olan kuvvet katsayısı olan K2 değerini 1 ile eksi 1 aralığında tercih ediyoruz. Diğer de aralıklarda zaten elastik modülü ve diğer yoğunluk değerlerini çok küçük değerlere dönüştürüyor. Yani anlamsız hale geliyor.
Yo, aslında aralıktan bahsetmemiştim. Rica etsem bir önceki slayta dönebilir misiniz? Bir önceki slayta. Üç farklı, evet, eksponansiyel ve polinomial malzeme gradyantından bahsediyoruz. Hani özellikle neden bu incelendi? Aslında merak ettiğim şey bu. Keyfi bir seçim mi?
Trigonometrik olarak aslında yani özel bir seçim olarak yani davranış özelliği açısından bunu özellikle göstermek istedik. Negatif ve pozitif değerler aldığında aynı değerlere ulaştığımızda üniformda ve kesit değişiminde de bizi farklı sonuçlara getirdiğini, yani istediğimiz daha doğrusu doğal frekans ve kritik yük değerlerini büyüttüğünü gördük. Ama negatif ve pozitiflerde aynı olduğunu gördük. Bunu göstermek amacıyla bunu tercih ettik.
Peki, çok teşekkür ediyorum. Thank you very
teşekkürler
much.
Teşekkürler hocam.
Başka sorusu olan var abi. Başka bu arada.
Question?
Yeah. I have a quick question to you, Dr. Sinner.
I think there is no question.
I'm here. I have a question.
Oh, okay, okay. Please ask your question. Yeah.
Dr. Sinner, I have...
Çok net anlayamıyorum. Kulaklığımda bir problem var sanırım da. Türkçe alabilir miyim?
Türkçe, Türkçe mi olsun?
Evet.
Tamam. Şimdi mekanik açısından stres, strain davranışları fonksiyonel uygulanan materyalda nasıl bir davranış gösteriyorlar? Normal bilinen çelik gibi olabilir ya da plastik malzemede gibi olabilir. Çünkü function grade material da ne özellik gösteriyor mekanik açısından? Onu böyle bir bilginiz
ya,
var mı?
Bu çalışmamızda stres analizi yapmadık. Yani o sorduğunuz analizleri yapmadık. Ancak çalışmamızın hani genel itibariyle kiriş teorisi üzerinden doğal frekans ve kritik yüklere yani sonu etkisini gözlemledik. Kritik yük üzerindeki etkisini değerlendirdik bu çalışmamızda. Başka bir çalışmada bunu açıklamak daha da uygun olur.
Tamam. Hani bu genel bir soruydu. Şimdi
evet, genel bir soruydu da şu anda çünkü uzayacak. Hani bununla konuyla bağlantılı olarak anlatmam biraz tamam. Zor olacak.
Sorun yok. Şimdi hocam, burada bu çalışmada kullandığınız yöntem sadece başka çalışmalar üzerinde mi yürüttüğünüz çalışma, yoksa özel bir program çözdünüz, o problemi çözdükten sonra mı sonuçlara vardınız? Şimdi çözdüğünüz problem hangi yöntemle çözdünüz? Analitik olarak mı?
Evet, matematik kirişim matematik modelinin diferansiyel kuantum, yani bu çalışma zaten çalışmamızın spesifik bir kısmı lineer matematik modeli üzerinden nümerik bir yöntemle çözümünü yaptık, değerlendirmesini yaptık.
Tamam. Eğer böyle bir resim gibi olsaydı bence daha uygun olurdu. Kendimiz de canlandırıcı bir şey olacaktı.
Evet, onu eksikliğini ben de şimdi fark ettim. Sunum esnasında çok fazla denklemlerle boğuşmuşum ama şöyle, aynen. Şu anda slide'da ekranında görebildiğiniz üzere genel olarak literatürden iyi bildiğimiz lisans seviyesinden diyebileceğim dördüncü mertebe kiriş lineer kiriş denklemi üzerinden ışıklığın gradient materyal özelliklerinde bu denkleme ekleyerek, ki gördüğünüz üzere EI yani hem kiriş ataletle alakalı olan terimlerimiz de X'e bağlı olarak değişiyor, hem de elastite modülü ve yoğunlukla ilgili değişkenlerimizin X'e değiştiğini görüyoruz. Bu denklemde yer ederek malzeme ve kesit değişimini denkleme dahil ederek sadece basit mesnet şartında diferansiyel kuantum yöntemiyle çözümünü yaptık. Yani analitik olarak bir yere kadar denklem elde etmesi, boyutsuzlaştırmamız ve sonrasında nümerik yöntem olan diferansiyel kuantum ile de doğal frekans ve kritik yük değerlerini hesapladık.
Başka bir sorumuz var mı acaba?
Sorunuzu biraz açıklayabilmiş olmamla.
Süremiz limitli. Başka bir soru var mı arkadaşlar?
Sunumu kısa tuttum ama birazcık sorularla açıklamaya çalışayım.
Tartışmamızda da fayda var. Eğer daha detaylı bilgi almak istiyorsanız oturum sonrasında irtibat kurabilirsiniz. Ben yeni bir başla açılış yapmak istiyorum. Başlığın açılışını. The title of new presentation is Compression After Impact Behavior of Laminated Composite Plates. Samet Kıyık will present, I think. Samet Kıyık.
Hello. Okay. I'm Samet Kıyık. My paper topic is compression after impact behavior of laminated composite plates. I will try to explain my study in details in this presentation. Aim of the research, in this study, S2 glass epoxy laminated composite at different thicknesses were produced by using the vacuum-assisted resin infusion method, VARM. 50-layer and 80-layer S2 glass composites were used to investigate the effect of thickness of the composite on compression after impact strength. Impact tests were conducted by using CIST 9350 Fractables plus impact test machine at 30 joule, 40 joule and 50 joule impact and unimpact energies. In order to determine the effect of the impact damage on the residual compressive strength of the specimen, composure after impact tests were carried out by using universal Shimatsu testing machine with Boeing compression after impact fixture for impacted and unimpacted specimen. Compression after impact strength of composites decreases with increase of impact energy. These materials we use S2 glass fibers and epoxy resin. Methodology. First, the manufacturing plate covered with mold release agent to prevent the epoxy from sticking to the plate and all edges covered with adhesive sealant. Subsequently, S2 glass fibers laid on the mold release agent, peel ply placed on S2 glasses. The reason for this is that S2 glasses can be adhered to the resin dispenser and vacuum back by this process. A resin dispenser placed on the peel ply to distribute the resin well. Finally, as shown in the figure on both sides, after the spiral pipes were placed, they are covered with a vacuum bag. After opening the vacuum and driving the air inside, leak check down. If there is no leakage after the control, the mixture of epoxy and hardener is prepared to that the hardener epoxy ratio is 1/3. In production process, pre-curing established at 50 Celsius for 30 minutes and then curing process applied at 80 Celsius for 8 hours. The specimens were cut at dimension of 100 to 150 millimeter. First, the impact tests were carried out by CIST 9350 Fractables plug impact test machine at 30 joule, 40 joule and 50 joule impact energies for different thicknesses. After that, the compression after impact tests were applied to composite specimens. In the given figure, CIST 9350 Fractables plus device is shown. The device had been used for impact test. Also, this device is universal Shimatsu testing machine used for compression after impact test. Results: 50 layer S2 glass epoxy composite thickness are 2.72 millimeter and 80 layer S2 glass epoxy composite thickness are 3.02 millimeter. 50 layer S2 glass epoxy composite are examined. It is first seen that the specimen with the highest resistance is 15 layer 0 joule without impact. Additionally, it is clearly seen that the lowest force is 50 layer 50 joule specimen. Maximum forces at compression after impact strength are given in the INT table. In this figure, the force displacement characteristics of 50 layer S2 glass epoxy material is presented. As it can be seen from the figure, maximum force of 38,225 Newton is achieved with the 15 zero joule without impact. As it's seen with the increase in energy of impact, maximum force is reduced alongside of composite after impact strength. The lowest maximum force belongs to the material 1550 joule applied with an impact energy force of 50 Newton. And the front and back view of the 50 zero joule sample after composition after impact test. And the front and back view of the 50 30 joule after composition after impact test. As it can be seen from the figure, the impact damage is in the middle and composition after impact damage is around the impact damage. Similarly, in 50-40 joule sample, composure after impact damage is around the impact damage. And final sample, 50-15 joule sample. The specimen with the highest strength resistance is the specimen that has not been exposed to 80 zero joule impact damage. The specimen with the lowest strength resistance is the specimen that has been exposed to 80-50 joule impact damage. The values of maximum force and composure after impact strengths are seen in table. Here the force displacement characteristics of 80 layer S2 glass epoxy material is presented. Just like the 50 layer sample, the maximum force and composition after impact strength belong to without damage sample. With the increase in impact damage, maximum strength and composition after impact strength is reduced. And the front and back view of the 80 zero joule after composure after impact test. Here is the front and back view of the 80-30 joule after a composure after impact test. As it can be seen from the figure, the impact damage is in the middle and composure after impact damage is around the impact damage, just like the 50 layer sample. The front and back view of the 80-40 joule sample after the composition after impact test. And finally, the front and back view of the 80-50 joule S2 glass epoxy specimen after the composition after impact test. Conclusion, in this study, the effect of impact energy and the thickness of composite on composition after impact strength were studied for S2 glass epoxy composite. Firstly, 50 layer and 80 layer S2 glass epoxy composites were subjected to 30 joule, 40 joule and 50 joule impact energies. Then composure after impact test was applied on impacted and unimpacted specimens. From obtained results, the following conclusion were drawn. 80 layer S2 glass epoxy composites has more composure after impact strength than 50 layers. The lowest composure after impact strength was revealed in the specimen with 50 joule impact energy applied for both 80 layer and 50 layer specimen. The highest composure after impact strength was the 50 and 80 layer S2 glass epoxy in unimpacted specimens This was followed by specimens with 30 joule and 40 joule impact energies respectively. Composure after impact damage occurred at the place where impact damage was applied. The reason for this can be said that stiffness of composite around the damaged area decreases, and therefore composure after impact damage starts from this region. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much for your presentation. Have you got any question? Any question? I want to ask a question. Do you have any results from the analyze, from the modeling?
No.
Do you plan, you mentioned about only experimental results.
Şöyle Türkçe cevap vereyim. Şeyden önce, bu COVID'den önce yapmayı planlıyorduk, fakat şu an makinamız bozuk. Parçamız İtalya'dan gelmiyor. O yüzden deneylerimiz zaten aksadı. Eğer gelirse yani bu yakın zamanda, hani deneylerimin tamamını yetiştirip hani tezim için, aynı zamanda modellemeyi de düşünüyorum, ama tabii parçanın gelip gelmemesiyle alakalı şu anda.
Yüksek lisans ya da doktora tezi hangisinde?
Şu an yüksek lisans. İnşallah bitince de doktoraya devam edeceğim.
Modelleme için de onu düşünüyorsunuz. Peki, teşekkür ederim. The last presentation is optimization study of ballistic impact tests on carbon-carbon composites. For this presentation, I want to invite Latif Tibet Aktaş.
Merhabalar.
Merhaba.
Is my voice clear or is there any voice at all?
Yes, okay.
That's okay. Let me share my screen. Okay. Hello everyone, my name is Latif Tibet Aktaş and I'm working as a research assistant in İzmir University of Economics in Mechanical Engineering Department. Also, I'm working on my PhD at Mechanical Engineering in İzmir Kadir Çelebi University. And I want to talk about the optimization study of impact tests on carbon-carbon composites, which I worked on with Dr. Levent Aydın. As a summary, in this study, it is intended to optimize a high-velocity impact case of a composite plate. The case is selected from the literature based on its dataset properties, the properties like amount of inputs and outputs, number of tests, physical relations with real-life situations, and relations between the properties studied on. The base study focused on failure response of advanced carbon-carbon composites under high velocity impacts. In the present study, two unique models are introduced within the scope of the present study as dimensionless damage areas of front and back sides of the composite. The equations found in the present study are trigonometric forms of the equations in the base study. A multiple nonlinear regression method is used for objective function of the optimization problem. And since the determination coefficient values have been found quite similar with the ones in the base study, the presented models in the study can be considered as successful to predict the results. Let me talk about the carbon composites. These composite systems are materials composed of carbon fiber reinforcement and a carbon matrix phase, and they are known about their unique behaviors. These relatively newly developed engineering materials show ceramic behavior in nature, but behaving range from pseudo plastic to brittle. These types of composite materials are all carbon composites with a reinforcing fiber phase and a matrix phase, both made up of carbon, and carbon-carbon composites are used in several industrial and medical applications, especially in re-entry nose tips of rockets, rocket nozzles, and aircraft brake discs, where their excellent thermostructural properties become critical. If you talk about the base study of this project, she and their friends studied both experimentally and analytically on high velocity impact effects on carbon-carbon composites at high temperatures. A fast electric heating system was used to obtain high temperatures in their study, and their study is taken as the base study for the present case. The figure below shows the schematic drawing of the two-stage light gas gun and the impact chamber. And in the experimental part of the base study, the projectiles were accelerated by two-stage light gas gun. The fast electric heating system mainly be composed of copper electrodes, a cooling water tank, and the voltage transformer. And both heating the carbon-carbon composite samples and measuring the temperature were done by the fast electric heating system. And in the base study again, 17 high-velocity impact tests were executed experimentally. The range for projectile velocity is 1,600 meters per second to 4,600 meters per second. And for experimental temperatures, it's 25 Celsius to 1,429 Celsius. The analytical part of the base study was conducted with the purpose of obtaining mathematical models of objective functions using the experimental results. An objective function is the target parameter to be maximized or minimized. And further predictions can be made by operating the models without the necessity of any experimental procedure. And about the models, these are the models of the base study. The first one expresses the dimensionless frontal damage area of the carbon-carbon composite plate. And the second one is about dimensionless back damage area of the composite. T0 is the room temperature, and this CT value is speed of sound in carbon-carbon composites. The methodology, about the methodology of this study, our study. In this present study, in order to simplify the mentioned models from the base study, the optimization process has been done using first-order trigonometric multiple nonlinear regression model on Wolfram Mathematica software. The results are compared by their convergence of determination coefficients. Determination coefficient is important in determining the quality of fit in regression analysis. Objective functions are constructed with the design variables, which are system inputs of the physical phenomena. The design variables are temperature of the composite plate, impact velocity of the projectile, and the ratio between the laminate thickness and the diameter of the projectile. Optimization studies applied on objective functions, which are system outputs of the physical phenomena. Two different models have been introduced in the present study by using first-order trigonometric multiple nonlinear regression method to predict the dimensionless damage areas, easier than and yet equally accurate to the models presented in the base study. And to obtain accurate models of objective functions, regression analysis method is used. Regression analysis method can accurately determine which variables have how much impact on the interested phenomena. One of the regression models is first order trigonometric multiple nonlinear regression function. The difference of this method from the other methods is modeling the dependent or criterion variables as a nonlinear function of model parameters and independent variables. And multiple form of nonlinear regression defines that there are more than one independent variables in the objective function. And for the present case, they are input types. And objective function simply indicates the contribution of each variable of the problem on the value to be optimized. And basically, objective function is a function of the decision variables that is to be maximized or minimized. And in the below, you can see the standard form of the first order trigonometric multiple nonlinear regression function. And optimization process has been done by using Wolfram Mathematica software. And design variables, which are system inputs, are defined. And for this case, the design variables are temperature of the composite sample, impact velocity of the projectile, and the ratio between the laminate thickness and diameter of the projectile. The objective functions define the system outputs, and they are dimensionless frontal damage area and dimensionless back damage area for the present case. And in the present study, the motto is to develop same equations presented in the base study, but in simpler forms, if possible, and as accurate as possible. And simple prediction equations can give the results with less time and process power. Reaching this objective will provide a better approach to important real-life applications of advanced carbon-carbon composite, such as aerospace industry and aeronautical structures under high velocity impacts. The models are obtained with first order trigonometric multiple nonlinear regression analysis. And after implementing appropriate minimization command in the software, the final models were able to give optimized input values, which are temperature of the composite plate, impact velocity of the projectile, and the ratio between the laminate thickness and diameter of the projectile. And with respect to the given any arbitrary output value, we can find them. To consider the models as successful, determination coefficients should be close as much as possible to one. And this is the defined criteria of the success of the present study. And the table below shows the obtained models of the case and their calculated determination coefficients. Okay, for the comparison of the models, these are the models of the base study and the models obtained in our study. Since the base models are exponential functions, obtained trigonometric models are, let me say, simpler forms of the base models in processing power terms. X1, X2, and X3 represent temperature of the composite plate, impact velocity of the projectile, and the ratio between the laminate thickness and diameter of the projectile, respectively. Determination coefficient study has been conducted with these two models. And the results and comparison of these results with the results given in the base study are shown in this table. Depending on the results, we can say that our model of dimensionless back damage area is more fitting and thus superior than the base model. And for dimensionless frontal damage area, the constraints are defined from the dataset presented in the base study, as all values should be between the minimum and maximum dataset values. After applying the constraints of the dataset, the output of the n minimized command in Mathematica gives the results in table 4 and 5. But let me say, for conclusion, optimization results show that the effect of the impact velocity on the impact resistance of carbon-carbon composites appears to be more important than the ratio between laminate thickness and diameter of the projectile. In spite of greater change in ratio between laminate thickness and diameter of the projectile value, slightly lesser value change of impact velocity gave greater back damage area value. And it appears to be more important than the ratio between laminate thickness and diameter of the projectile. In the present study, as conclusion, to determine the dimensionless damage areas, two novel equations are presented. The optimization process has been done by using Wolfram Mathematica software, and the name models presented in this study show good determination coefficient agreements with the ones in the base study. And finally, global minimum optima values of outputs are found with applied constraints. According to the global optima results, it is seen that the impact velocity is more effective than the ratio between laminate thickness and diameter of the projectile on the ballistic resistance of carbon-carbon composites. Also, dimensionless damage area can be minimized by decreasing the ratio between the laminate thickness and diameter of the projectile. And thank you for your concern and thank you for your patience.
Thank you very much for your presentation. I can take question. Have you got any questions? I think there is no question. Sunumla ilgili herhangi bir soru var mı arkadaşlar?
Yok galiba.
Okay, I want to end second conclusion of the 4th International Student Science Congress. Thank you very much for your attending and contribution.
Thank you.